Good morning. Here I am camping, beautiful Lake Huron. And I thought I'd share with you the way that I start my practice down here on the beach on those gorgeous mornings. I get to play at the Great Lakes. I'm going to start on hands and knees on my mat. Finding table pose. My toes first, lifting the toes, wiggling the toes, pointing the toes, flexing the ankles. Sometimes you need extra padding underneath your knees. I've got a blanket in my bag if I need it. The sand is stuck on me today. Rolling the ankles around in a circle, one direction, then the other direction. Little wake up tap there on the floor. Okay. Let's begin moving with the fingers. If your knees are really stiff, I always carry a block with me. I can use that to cushion so I don't have to bend my knees all the way. You can stand up to do this. So I'm doing the same thing with my hands that I did with my feet. Getting them warmed up. Okay, I'm back into the table pose. I'm going to start working with my right leg, ready to go today. So inhale, lifting the right leg straight up. Exhale, moving the chest. Notice I'm trying to keep my hips fairly level to the sand beneath me. I'm not really trying to cat and cow. This is focused on the hip. Once I've done a few movements like that, inhale, open it straight out to the side and bring the knees back together. Notice again, I'm not lifting my hip right up, imitating the dogs I see out on the walks I take Natalie on. This is a pretty targeted movement for specific muscles in the hip joint. Then once that's done, I'll put the legs straight, parallel to the earth. Now I'll take some time to turn the thigh bone out. When I turn the thigh bone out, the knee and the toe faces out to the side. And then I'll tuck the thigh bone under. As I do this in coordination with my breath, notice the levelness of my hips doesn't really change. You see movement in the hip joint, but it's not lifting up and down. And about three of those is fine on each side. Let's do that on the left side. Bring the left leg up and out to the side like we did with the right. Try to keep my breath pretty slow. I want these movements to be relatively a little bit boring. So my brain has lots of time to think about what I'm doing. Now I'm getting into the rolling of the leg bone rolls out. And you can see things are staying fairly parallel to the floor. Bam. And that really helps keep this movement isolated in my head. Worked my hips out pretty good. I'm going to work a little bit on my shoulders. You might find the block helpful for this, just to take pressure off your knees. You can sit on it in between your ankles, heels, and your sitting bones. You can also tuck a bolster there if you're in the studio. Okay, shoulders. First thing you like to think about when you want to work, warm up your shoulders is what's going on in the shoulder blades. That's part of the joint. So I'm going to take my shoulder blades and I'm going to hug them together and then spread them apart. So you're seeing movement in my arms and that might be where your attention goes. But it's really the movement of those shoulder blades on my back. This can be timed with breath as well. Inhaling with the shoulder blades squeeze. And exhaling. Let's release into further movement. Inhaling. Exhaling. It's a great time to assess your ability to do down dog today. If the arms don't come back you've got some shoulder stuff going on, and maybe down dog's not your pose today. Take a child's pose instead. And the last move with your shoulders is an inhale and cactus arms, and reversing that into an internal rotation on the exhale. This is a free range of motion. So if you have soreness in your shoulders, this is helping to unwind it. There's no pressure on the joint, no forcing on the joint. So that's our legs and arms ready to go for whatever exciting thing comes next for you today. We're talking about a bike ride, hoping to see some old friends that I used to play with when I came camping here decades ago. I'm not talking about these decades. So this movement might be familiar to anyone who's done any yoga class. One thing about extending the spine, really extending the chest forward of the arms. So really a pull forward, simultaneously I'm reaching and lengthening with the tailbone area. So I'm trying to get the maximum length of my spine. The belly is still fairly tight in, it's not hanging towards the ground. That's the inhale. And on the exhale, as you tuck the tailbone under, round out the back, pull the belly muscles in, spread the shoulder blades again, and finally drop the head. A few smooth breaths like that. Inhale. Leg and arm movements, now it kind of brings it all together in the brain. Just a little variation to wake up the side body called gate pose. If you found that this was difficult to weight bear on your knee, do the same movement with your legs standing straight. On an inhale, I want to really extend the side of my body nice and long. And on the exhale, create a little half moon shape. Inhale, reach back up. And exhale, nice half moon shape. I can feel this whole side of my body starting to come alive. Torso lengthening. And after about three or so breaths, ready to come back onto the other side. So on this side, I'm just going to demonstrate the standing version. You can stay where you were if you're happy there. I'm also going to demonstrate what to do if you have a sore shoulder. So instead of holding the arm up, you can leave the hand on your hip. Same pose. Inhale, extend this side of the body long. Exhale. That's one way to modify this. The knee is sore, or the shoulder is sore, or you might have stayed to our original version. Again, three or four breaths are probably enough. We're going to step to a standing position now, facing one end of your mat. One foot slightly forward of the other. Both feet are firmly planted on the ground. You may have to play around with the angle on this back leg. The toe can be out, rotated in a bit more, as long as both feet. And it's easy for me when I'm practicing my stand here, so I want to see equal depth of footprints under each of my feet. My front knee is going to bend a little bit. I'm going to start by opening up that chest again, so big inhale. And on the exhale, I'm going to pull the belly muscles in. And I'm going to twist towards my front leg. Put a beautiful Google leg. Inhale, open back up. And exhale, both feet stay really firmly planted. Maybe as you twist,
take your gaze over this way. Imagine you're looking at this beautiful lake. And about three breaths are enough. We're just warming up. As you come back to your mountain pose, just kind of evaluate how that felt. You can take the other side. The other leg steps back. I bend the front knee a bit. I find myself grounded and planted in both legs. Inhale, embrace the abundant thought all around you. Exhale, forward, pull forward, and a little bit of a twist, pull the belly in. Always hold that pose for a couple of breaths if you felt it was really helpful. Now you can complete your practice with a few minutes of silent meditation or breath work, or go on to something else if there's some other things that you're working on. I hope you have a beautiful, gorgeous day.